Building. This is a short demonstration of the SqueezePad and how to make playlists. If we fire up the SqueezePad application and I have a selection of players, I'll choose my SqueezePad Touch, which is a brilliant digital audio converter streaming device, no longer made. Let's check my music. And I'm going to search for an album by Bocelli. Now, as all the albums are cached, it's found instantly. Open up the album. Let's say I want to select a few songs from my playlist. I'll press 1 and keep my finger pressed. Press play next. You can see the artwork comes up. I pull out the playlist tab. There's one song there. Now let's choose another song by doing the same thing, add to the end, a third song, add to the end. Now my playlist now has 3 songs. I don't like the order, I can drag them around a little bit. If I don't like a particular song, I can swipe and delete, then add another song. Now I can save this selection and order as a named playlist, so let's call it. And I'll save that by pressing send. Let's close that tab. Just while we're here, there's an interesting tab which gives an internet connection and automatically searches Wikipedia for the entry on the artist, and you can read about his discography and so on while you're listening to the brilliant music. Now, if I press the home screen at the bottom left, get back to the home menu, press my music. Now near the bottom there's playlists, and you can see I'll press down and hold Bocelli, and there's information about that particular playlist. Now to just briefly demonstrate this playing, I will select the iPad, which has got the ability to play directly onto the iPad if you pay an extra couple of pounds with SqueezePad to license it. I'll go to my music and choose playlists again, go back to that playlist I've created, and if I press play, with a bit of luck, it should start to play the music. Very brief clip, not to infringe copyright, but have great fun with SqueezePad and playlists. This is Tony McDonald. Thank you for listening.